Hi guys, so today we're gonna unbox a Toshiba Dynabook. Toshiba Dynabook. It's a laptop that I haven't heard a long time ago.
Now that's a name I've not heard in a long time. A long time.
May nagbebenta pa rin actually nito sa mga online platforms like a Facebook Marketplace or yung mga OLX Tipid PC. So it's been 4 years ago or 5 years ago na nagbebenta kami ng Toshiba Dynabook. And then all of a sudden, hindi na kami nagbebenta ng mga ganito kasi wala nang supply na dumadating. Now, may kita nyo pa rin naman to sa mga ibang online platforms like yung mga OLX Tipid PC, yung mga nagbebenta ng mga second hand. Dati kasi ang tawag pa dito mga Toshiba Satellite, tapos yan, nauso yung mga Dynabook. So ngayon, eto, bumabalik ulit si Toshiba Dynabook. And guys, actually, hindi siya mabenta dito sa Pilipinas, pero mabenta to sa ibang bansa. Now, just a quick brief history about Toshiba Dynabook. This is actually originated in Japan. Toshiba Dynabooks are made in Japan. And ang owner ng Toshiba Dynabook is the Sharp Company. Yung Sharp, yung alam niyo, mga refrigerators, yung mga aircons, yung mga washing machine. So they actually own Toshiba Dynabook. So, tingnan natin kung itong Dynabook na to ay magiging competitive katulad sa mga brands na makilala natin. So, let's go ahead and unbox this unit. By the way, after this video, magbibigay nga pala kami ng dalawang power bank, which is a Fujitsu. So, this also made in Japan, katulad ng Dynabook. Please watch video until the end, baka ikaw ang manalo ng mga power banks na ito. And if you want to win a giveaway, just simple, just like our page, subscribe to our channel, and click that notification bell, baka ikaw ang manalo. And pagdating natin 100,000 subscribers, magbibigay tayo ng laptop. Now, let's proceed. Buksan na natin tong laptop na ito. Okay, so let's open this unit. Once you open, ayan, meron may nakabunga dito na welcome sa box. So there are printed materials on this unit. So it's covered with plastic. And then, may kasama siyang cloth. Sana kahit yung mga ibang manufacturers meron din kasamang cloth. Especially yung mga laptop na fingerprint magnet. Sana nagsasama sila ng cloth sa units nila para hindi na nahihirapan yung buyers ang bibili ng pamunas. So, on the charger, we got here 19 volts. That's 2.37 ampere, 45 watts. So, yung saksakan niya. Now, let's talk about the appearance of this unit. Alright, so it's actually color black. There's no other accent on it. It's made in plastic. So guys, may plastic sa likod. Siyempre, pag mas ma-appreciate nyo yung design niya, tatanggalin nyo yung plastic pag nag-unbox kayo. So by the way, ang texture din ng laptop na ito, hindi siya yung ganun ka-smooth. Kasi may, ayun, marinig nyo. From the body, from the cover, kahit sa ilalim. So ito talaga parang rough. There's a logo of a Dynabook here, and then there's a logo of a Tekra here, and there's an Intel Celeron sticker. Sa ilalim, there's a fan. So a Celeron with a fan, not bad. Kasi halos lahat ng mga Celeron na na-encounter namin walang fan eh. Ito merong fan eh. Hindi kayo magkakaroon ng problema dito about cooling. Now let's talk about the ports of this unit. So on this side, we got here the power socket, and then a USB Type-C, that's 3.1, an HDMI port, and then an audio combo jack. And we have here a micro SD card. On the other side of the laptop, we got here two USB 3.0, and this is actually a sleep and charge may icon here. And then there's an RJ45 and a Kensington lock. Let's talk about the dimension of this unit. The width is 12.44 inch. The depth is 9 inch, while the height is 0.8 inch. The weight of this unit is 1.2 kilograms. The viewing angle of this unit is somewhat of 100. This is somewhat of 150 degrees. So, tingin ko bibili na kami ng protractor para maging accurate yung viewing angle namin. Now, let's talk about the specification of this unit. And the processor of this unit is Intel Celeron 5205U. The base boost is 1.9 GHz and it comes with 2 cores and 2 threads. Now, this laptop doesn't come with a turbo boost. Normally kasi yung mga Celeron na alam natin is Celeron with the N letter and then may the numbers. This doesn't come with the letter. It only comes with a number and then it doesn't have turbo boost. The memory of this unit is 4GB and it's 2400MHz. The storage is 128GB SSD, so that's a PCIe. And the operating system is Windows 10 Pro Education. So, first time lang ako na-encounter ng Windows 10 Pro Education. Now, we're just gonna do a research about it and we're gonna put a comment kung ano yung ibig sabihin ng Windows 10 Pro Education. The display adapter of this unit is Intel Ultra HD graphics. So, that's an integrated, not a dedicated. Now, the resolution of this unit is 13.3-inch and that's a full HD 920x1080. This is actually an IPS level display. So about the nits of this unit, we don't actually know, but it's actually giving us true color accuracy. Actually, parang mas mataas pa nga yung nits nito compared sa mga gaming laptops na meron ng mga video editors namin ngayon. We actually tried to search the internet. Ang i5 pati i7 variant nito is running more than 400 nits. We're also assuming that this might be up more than 400 nits. But if you know the answer, please comment down below because your feedback highly appreciated. So right now, I'm testing the camera of this unit, the Toshiba Dynabook. It's running a 0.9MP just like other laptop, but napansin ko dito mas maganda yung camera niyang 0.9MP compared sa mga ibang laptops kasi meron kami ng mga na-vlog na 0.9MP pero ang pangit talaga ng quality, but medyo umangat dito ang Toshiba. And by the way, what you're hearing right now is the audio quality of this unit. So typing test, I was able to score 36 words per minute. Yun yung pinakamababa ko. And actually, I do another retake. I ended up 30 words per minute. So mas bumaba yung words per minute ko. So I'm not sure, medyo nababaguhan na ata ako dito sa keyboard ng Toshiba Dynabook na ito. And I also noticed that every time I press the backspace, hindi backspace ang napipindot ko, yung equal sign. Probably it will take time for me para masanay dito sa keyboard na to. But don't get me wrong, kasi normal naman yung keyboard na to. Hindi siya abnormal, okay? This is a non-alphanumeric keyboard because it's not 15 inches. And then, di rin siya backlit keyboard. The tracking pad of this laptop is hindi rin ganun kalakihan compared sa mga ibang laptop. I might grade it na medyo maliit yung size ng tracking pad niya. So there you have it. I already told you the specifications of this unit. Now, baklasin naman natin to kung ano pa yung pwedeng i-upgrade dito. Tawagin natin yung technician natin para i-remove yung chassis. You don't like the lights, but it's camera time. Said take the picture, but you rolled your eyes. Now I'm mortified, I'm still terrorized. So thank you sa technician natin na nag-open ng chassis. So what I could see here, currently may nakakabit na 4GB memory. Now ito, pwedeng tanggalin to, tapos pwede ka maglagay ng 8GB or 16GB. Pero tingin ko ang pinaka-advisable for a Celeron, okay na yung 8GB memory. The word okay is in case na kinakapos ka ng memory, pero kasi normally sa Celeron, okay na rin naman yung 4GB. Now, this is running a 128 SSD, however, wala akong nakikita na SSD na nakabit dito. So, meaning to say, the SSD is kasama sa board, okay? There's actually a fan here, and then the processor is here. Now, katulad na sinabi ko, hindi lahat ng Celeron may fan. Normally, yung mga Celeron, di na nila nilalagyan ng fan. Pero, kudos kay Toshiba, hindi kayo magkakaroon ng problema ng overheating. Kahit kasi Celeron to, meron pa siyang fan. And the battery is here, Wi-Fi card is here. So, just to sum it up, ang pwede mo lang ikabit or pwede mo lang i-upgrade dito, it's either papalitan yung memory. So, it's tatanggalin mo yung 4GB, papalitan mo ng 8GB or 16GB. For the storage, if you want to add a storage, advisable naman magkabit ng micro SD card. So, itabi na natin to and then let's talk about the pros and the cons of this unit. Let's talk about the pros of this unit. First of all, yung display ng laptop na ito. Ang ganda-ganda ng screen resolution niya. It's a full HD sa Celeron. Tapos, yung nits niya, sobrang taas. I think it's actually more than 200 or more than 300. Kasi yung mga predecessors niya, yung i5 or yung i7, lumalagpas ng 400. We actually compared this sa ibang gaming laptop and medyo mas mataas pa ang brightness nito compared sa mga gaming laptops ng video editors namin. And another pros of this unit, it's its camera. Yes, it's running a 0.9MP pero kasi mas maganda yung quality ng camera nito compared sa mga ibang laptop na na-vlog namin. Yung mga ibang laptop, yes, they're also running a 0.9MP pero mas klaro or mas maganda yung quality ng camera na ito. Lastly, ang pros ng unit na to is its fan. Katulad sinabi ko, hindi lahat ng Celeron meron fan. Now, kung meron fan to, hindi kayo magkakaroon ng overheating issues. Now, let's talk about the cons of this unit. Okay, so unang-una, this laptop does not come with a turbo boost. Katulad na sinabi ko, it only runs with a base boost. Hindi katulad ng mga ibang Celeron na meron turbo boost, this laptop only comes with a base boost. However, kahit base boost lang to, it's 1.9 GHz. Normally, yung mga ibang Celeron na na-encounter namin, ang base boost lang nila is nasa 1.1 or 1.4. This is already a 1.9, parang turbo boost na siya dun sa mga ibang laptop. Probably that is why meron siyang fan kasi medyo mataas ang base boost nito. So sino ba ang target market ng unit na ito? First of all, this is actually ideal sa mga students kasi mura lang yung laptop na ito. I'll tell you the price later. And secondly, napaka-ideal nito doon sa mga customers natin na gumagawa ng photo editing and video editing. Now, we're talking about simple photo and simple video editing kasi Celeron pa rin to. If you're a photo editor, you're gonna go for an i5 or an i7 kasi you're using Adobe, mga ganyan. Pero if you're just doing some basic photo editing and basic video editing, bagay na bagay sa inyo to. Kasi unang-una, ang ganda ng display na to. It's a full HD IPS level with around 300 or 400 nits.
Yung mga old version na Photoshop, pwede naman.
So, ayun, katulad na sinabi ng video editor namin, pwede siya sa mga lumang version na Adobe Photoshop. So, about the price, binibenta namin to sa Laptop Factory around 17,500. And sometimes we're doing a sale. Baka maabutan nyo mas mababa sa 17,500. So, on that price, does it sound reasonable? Full HD IPS display, 13.3-inch na naka 4GB 128 SSD, Celeron. It's up to you. Now, sa mga tao naka-purchase na nito, please, if you do have feedbacks, comment down below because your feedback is highly appreciated. Para sa mga bagong customer, aware sila kung ano yung binibilan nilang unit. If you're interested buying this unit, we do have branches nationwide. We also have installment. And in case na ayaw nyo pumunta sa store namin due to this pandemic, nagka-cash on delivery naman kami. So, after this video, magbibigay kami ng dalawang Fujitsu power bank. Okay, so kung gusto nyo manalo ng mga giveaway, simple lang, like our page, subscribe to our channel, and click that notification bell. Kasi pagdating natin ng 100,000 subscribers, magbibigay kami ng laptop. Okay, so I think sinabi ko na lahat about sa giveaway and sa laptop na ito. Then again, this is Dustin from Laptop Factory. Have a good day. Bye-bye. Welcome back to our channel. Hello.
Ayoko na good.
Toshiba Dynabook. It's sabi to sa script na yun. Toshiba Dynabook. Ah! Nakalimutan ko yung sasabihin. Okay, Toshiba Dynabook. Yeah. This is... Ah, okay, yan ba yan? Toshiba Dynabook.
This is the name that I heard.